Hello and good day. My name is Chris Palmer with grayhatseo.com. In today's video, I'd love to share with you the Wayback Machine and Internet Archive SEO tips and status codes. So I've gotten this question very recently, literally moments ago. I was asked, hey, what do these different colors inside of the Wayback Machine mean? Like, what exactly do they signify? On top of that, I continuously get asked, what should I do if I find an expired or an archived domain? How do I set it up? Do I need to launch the same content? What do I need to do? So I'm going to outline for you very quickly exactly what these status codes are and what you need to do if you find an expired domain. So let's not waste any time here. Let's get directly into first and foremost, the status codes. So what you'll want to do is head over to the Wayback Machine. All right. So this is also known as the web archive. So let's just head out to here. We'll go here. All right. And we'll go right into the Wayback Machine. So this is the Wayback Machine. It's web.archive.org. So let's go ahead and look up a domain. All right. So I'll share with you a past domain that I've 301'd. It's my name. It's ChrisPalmerSEO.com. All right. What I'll point out to you first and foremost is this bar that's up at the top. So these are the years that it's been online, and this is when the web archive was scanning the particular site, right? In this case, it's ChrisPalmerSEO.com. So as you look down, you'll see different dates, right? You can see January and February, March, it's an entire calendar. You can also go back by year. As you can see, 2025, 2024. Let's go back to 2021. So when I first set this up, it was for a contest with my good friend, Craig Campbell, SEO. We were just playing around back and forth. And here you can see there was a bunch of scans. Now, how do I know that there were scans? Because each of these blue dots signify in a status code, which is called status code 200. This is a server status code. So blue, this will signify 200. That means it was a good scan. All right. So if we take a look at this, if I click on this, and this is a big one, you can see that the whole site was scanned. It's blue, status code 200. So as you can see here, there's 31 captures. Now let's go through the rest of the color codes because there's blue, there's orange, there's green, and there's red. So let's talk about those. Let's see if we can find a couple of them. All right. So if we come over here to 2024, we can see green. So when we take a look at green, we can see that green, as you can see here, that will signify a 300 status code. 300 could be a 301 or a 302. So a 301 would mean that it's a permanent redirect. 302 means that there was a temporary redirect. Either way, there's a redirect in place. And who would have thought? I've redirected this to my new domain. So on top of this, there's also going to be orange and red. All right. Now, I don't believe there should be any oranges or reds. All right. But orange, let's just say that on October 31st, instead of this being blue, it was orange. This would signify a status code of 400. Now, the only 400 code that I ever use is a 410. And this means page does not exist. So orange means error 400 or status code 400 does not exist. Along with that, here, I'll look this up. So how about status code 400? All right. So a status 400 or a bad request indicates the server could not understand the request due to invalid syntax. Also, invalid URL, incorrect request body, malware, client-side issues. 410, as we just talked about, means gone. It no longer exists. All right. Last but not least is the dreaded 500. Now, I do not believe that I have any of these. We could take a quick look. Nope. But if you were to see a red dot, all right, this is the status code 500. So let's just say that on June the 16th, instead of this being blue, it was red. Status red will mean 500. What is a status code 500? That is the worst. That means the server is down. And for better or for more technical terms, let's look up a status code 500, also known as internal server error. So just to quickly go through these, all right? Blue, this means status code 200. This site was good. The crawl is good. Green means it was a 301 or a 302. That means there was a redirect. Orange means a 400 or a 410. Page gone, bad request. Red, This will mean that its server is gone, internal error, bad, all right? So these are the different status codes. When you come to web.archive.org and you're looking down and you can see the different colors, this is what they mean. Now, a question that I get, all right, to give you some tips here, are, Chris, when I find a domain, what exactly should I do? Which pages should I launch? Should I launch the same content? And here's my best advice, beginner advice or intermediate advice. So here's what we do and here's the process. So let's just say that you found chrispalmerseo.com. This is a past domain of mine. I've redirected it. The very first thing that we want to take a look at, all right, and let's just say we've already identified that it's a good domain and I'm logged into SEMrush. What I want to do is I want to scroll down the page under backlink analytics in SEMrush or using your favorite SEO tool. And what we want to take a look at are the top pages. Why? Because I want to see what are the top pages with referring domains. In this case, we can see that it's the homepage, homepage, then there's a Las Vegas page. And then on top of that, we have a www version, which is a subdomain. And then again, the homepage. So really at the end of the day, all of the links are pointing to two pages. So what do we do? Let's go over to our handy dandy whiteboard and let's just use this example. So we have HTTP, right? /chrispalmer.org. And then you're going to have your HTTPS, Chris Palmer, or, my mistake, Chris Palmer, SEO, all right, .com. .org is the new domain. Chris Palmer, SEO.com. All right. So we noticed that the HTTP, then there was also this HTTP, HTTP, right? www.chrispalmerseo.com. Now, usually any sites or any expired or archive that you have, if there's any links pointing to the HTTP or a subdomain like www, remember, nowadays we want HTTPS, right? 2025. So you're going to redirect if there were good links or if there are good links. We want to redirect HTTP requests and www old requests to the new domain. So if you decide to sit on the root or if you're going to use HTTPS www, you want to redirect all of these past home pages with the www without the non-HTTPS requests, we want to forward to our newest domain when we were to set it up, all right? That way, we're redirecting all those links, if they were any good, back to the homepage. Now, let's talk about our internal page, because as you saw here, using this as an example, we can see that this internal page has 59 referring. Without looking at the links, without looking at anchors, without identifying if they're quality, let's just say that we want them. What we want to do then is we want to set this URL up when we're creating our pages exactly how it was before. So what this means is we want to create a page that's identical to this, but it doesn't stop there. We need to have chrispalmerseo.com, same URL, so this is a HTTPS, non-www version, and then it's lost-vegas-digital. If we want those links, we set this page up exactly how it was as far as the URL parameters. The next step that I love to do is we want to go ahead and do this. So we want to head back over to the web archive, okay? And we want to take a look at a really good scan when there was a blue status code. This means, again, status code 200. We're then going to take a look at the exact page that previously existed. So we'll type it in when there was the most. We'll search for it. I've got a status code 300. All right, we'll head on back. See, these things happen. All right, so we take a look at this. We'll go in here to green. All right, green will generally mean that there was a 301. But we can take a quick look and see it was 301 to a new page. But what we want to take a look at, just because I can't get an example, is let's just say that we pulled this up and it was a good page. All right. Because all these pages, these are green. Obviously, I knew they were going to be redirected. But let's just say, all right, we go to a blue. All right. the whole, everything's redirected. Here's what you want to do. Let's just pretend that this was the site real quick. We come on in here, hit blue. Bear with me here. I just want to show you quickly. This is a really good example. Look at all of these scans and all the colors. So what we will do is we will take a look at the page that previously existed. And what we want to look at is we want to look at the title. We also want to look at the H1 and any text that may have been there, but most notably the parameter in the URL. So the URL parameters. All right. We then also want to outline this. So here, I'll just make a quick note. So the URL, same. All right. Title of the page, same. All right. H1 of the page, same. And this is how we will get this page indexed, right? Because we want to recover all of those links. But I'll give you one more tip. So this identifies what each of the status codes mean. This also identifies to you how to identify the pages that have the links. We walk through SEMrush. On top of that, we know how to set the pages back up. But what about all the other links, right? How do we ensure that everything is going to show back up potentially? So here's what we do, and this will be a more intermediate tip for you, but here's the process. When you're identifying your sites, you've done your research, let's just say that this was a winner. What you want to do is you want to go into your favorite SEO tool. I'm inside of SEMrush. You go into link building, backlink analytics, all right? And we're going to go to backlinks, not referring domains. And what we want to do is we want to export this entire list, all right, of backlinks pointing to the actual pages. The very next step is go to your favorite indexing service. You can come over to chrispalmer.org or go over to any of your favorite indexing services. And what you want to do is you take that entire backlink list. If you want to clean it, you can. And I'll share with you in a second what I mean by clean. But go to indexing and submit that index, the backlinks to an indexing service. This way, each of the links get recrawled, re-indexed, I re-get credit, and hopefully I can regain all of that past juicy link juice. Here's the last piece I'll give you, all right? Last tip. If you want to clean this, as you can see here, we're looking at backlinks. If you want to clean your list, what you're looking for is how many external links on the site that you got a backlink from are there. So for instance, I got a link from this site right here, Kids Lab, right? But that site has 8,000 outbound links. So the value of this link, even though the authority score is a 49, is very low. However, if you come down here to MapQuest, I know MapQuest has tons, but look at this, external links on this page, 5. So that would mean that that link is more powerful, right? So this is how you would clean a list based upon external links on the page I got a link from. And this walks through the process of what the status codes are, how to see which pages have the most links to rebuild. I've also walked through how to rebuild the pages, what to have, URLs, H1s, titles. Along with that, how to maximize the amount of links that show back up on the expired or archived domains. My name is Chris Palmer with grayhatseo.com and, of course, chrispalmer.org. And I look forward to seeing you in the next Wayback Machine Internet Archive SEO Tips and Status Codes video. I'll see you in the next one. Have a good day. Bye-bye.